Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video I am going to explain you about all 16 HIVE analytical functions with examples in real time scenarios that are useful for Hadoop and Spark. Before going to this topic, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, like it and click on bell button. Okay, coming to HIVE analytical functions. HIVE analytical functions are available from HIVE 0.11 version onwards. These are special group of functions that scan the multiple input rows to compute each output value. These are usually used with over, partition by, order by, and also with windowing specification. These are different from the actually we know about aggregate functions used with group by class. So these are different from the aggregate functions used with the group by class. Group by class, those aggregate functions are that is limited to one result value per group. But analytical functions operate on windows where the input rows are ordered and grouped using flexible condition expressed through an over partition clause. So even though analytical functions give aggregate results, they don't group the result set. They return the group value multiple times with each record. We will see in our practical session. The analytical function offer great flexibility and functionalities than the regular group by class. So now we discuss what are all the analytical functions theoretically. Later we will see how to execute them. Okay, now we have 16 analytical functions that are count, sum, min, max, average, rank, dense rank, row number, comdist, percent rank, entile, lead, lag, first value, last value, and final one is sampling. The syntax for analytical functions is, first we give function of arguments, argument 1 to argument n, and then we use over, partition by, order by, at the end window class. So I already told you we use this function along with over, partition by, and order by along with window specification. So here count, we already know how total number of counts of the employees in a department and sum of the salary, minimum of salary and maximum salary and average of salary. Already we know, I have provided example query here that we are going to execute now. Next function is rank. It ranks the items in a group, such as finding the top n rows for specific conditions. So this is one, already we know it. Next, dense rank. It is also similar to rank, but leaves no gaps in the ranking sequence where there are ties. If two players are tied for one place, then the next rank will give will give the next rank in case of dense rank. But in rank it leaves the space, but in dense rank it won't leave the space after the second place. Okay, that we will see. Next, row number. A unique number, sequence number is given to all the records that starts from 1 to up to how many records are there, that many sequence numbers will be given in sequential order. Next, come dist. It computes the number of rows. It gives the total number of rows divided by current row. For example, we have four elements. It gives for the first 0.25, second 0.5, third 0.75, and last one 1. Okay. Next, percent rank. This is in the name itself, we have rank. It depends on rank value. So it is similar to cumdist, but it depends on rank value and provide the percent rank. That is current rank minus 1 divided by total number of rows minus 1. Okay. Next, entile. It divides the order set into buckets. Suppose we have 4 records, so we divided, we have giving 2 buckets, then for 4 buckets 2 records will be divided, and for the first record it will be given 1 1, second record 1 2, and for the second bucket again 2 2, 2 3, and 2 4 will be given. So here it is divided into buckets. The total records will be divided into number of buckets that are given by us. Lead. The next row of the record, will be given using lead function. If there are single record is there, then it gives, that means it returns null value. Next, lag. It returns previous row for the specified record. If there is only one record, it returns null value. Next function is first value. It returns the first result from an order set. Next, last value. In our order set, it returns last value of the record. And the final function is sampling. Suppose if we have a large data set, and for sampling purpose we need few of the records, so we have to take subset of the data set. We have large data set, from that we need subset of data set because we have some requirement, so we need some of the records. We don't need all of the records in our large data sets, so we have to take sample data from large data. So we go for sampling. Here we have three types of samplings are there: random sampling, bucket table sampling, and block sampling. Here, random sampling, here we use rand along with limit keyword for random sampling, and also we use distribute and sort keywords to get more performance. Here we are getting random sampling, not sequential data. Okay, we have to remember that. So if you use distributed sort keywords, the performance will be good. So earlier we know about random sampling using order by rand, but using rand function along with distribute and sort keywords, the performance is very good. In real time, they will ask how to improve the performance of our query. That is performance tuning. To get more performance, we use rand limit along with distribute and sort. Next one is bucket table sampling. In bucket table sampling can be applied only on bucket tables. In the name itself, we have mentioned bucket. The table should be bucketed. Then only we can apply sampling, bucket table sampling. So here we use cluster by and also table sample statements for more efficient along with rand function. Earlier we used distribute and sort keywords along with rand and limit functions in random sampling. Similarly here use along with the table sample we use cluster by along with rand function to get more performance. We take the sample from a table. The table should be bucketed. And then third one is block sampling. Here we take the sample of data, that means sample of data randomly. We have to remember that we are getting the samples randomly. Here we take the samples n percent of the data, some percent, 10%, 20%, 30%, like that. Otherwise, if you want to specify the length, we can specify the length of the total table. Otherwise, we can mention number of rows of the table. If you mention 4 rows, 5 rows, 6 rows, you will give that many records. Here we used partition by statement in every query. So what we do is partition is nothing but it partitions the columns, that is table data, into partitions, that many partitions. If you provide logically, that means for example we have 4 records in our table. If you want to partition logically into two records will be partitions. Again, after partition we go for ordering, then using order by class. Order by class order the data inside partition. After completing partition we go for order by. So order by class is used to order the records in every partition. Next is window specifications. We have row type of window specification. Here rows between starting expression and ending expression, we have provided the syntax here. This is the rows between, and this is one row type of window specification. Here start expression can be any of unbound preceding current row and end preceding or following, and end expression can be any of the following, that is unbound following, current row, end preceding or following. And then next one is between and class, that is used to provide start and end point. Here we discuss about unbound preceding, current row, and end preceding in the next slide. End preceding or following. This indicates end rows before or after the current row. End preceding means it specifies the before the point of specification. Following means after the point of specification. Unbound preceding means it also specifies first row of the partition and it points the start point specification, not the end point. Unbound following specifies the last row of the partition and it provides endpoint specification. Unbound following cannot be used for start point specification. Okay. And last one is unbound preceding and unbound following. In this case, we can provide. It indicates both first and last rows point of specifications. That means whole table. That means all rows in a table. That means all table. Okay. So I think you got each and everything. Now we go for workouts.
Friends, now we go for workouts. Now we will execute all the HIVE analytical functions, that is count, sum, min, max, average, rank, dense rank, row number, condensed, percent rank, entire, lead, lag, first value, last value, sampling. We go one by one. First we see the sample data. We load the sample data in our local machine, that is employee data. Okay, what we are seeing here, we load into HIVE table. So before loading into HIVE table, we create HIVE table. HIVE table name is employee HWHW, that is employee table. We are going to create employee table here. So table is created. Now load sample data. So we are loading employee sample data into our HIVE table. HIVE table name is employee_sw_hw. Now data is loaded into employee table. So we will check, we will verify whether the data is loaded or not. So data is loaded. Employee name, department number, employee ID, salary, type of the employee, and start date or joining date. So now we execute one sample query, like we select few of the fields before going to analytical functions. Now I have I am going to select employee name, department number and salary from employee table. So our job started running. Still running. For the first time, it is taking more time. For launching mappers and reducers. After for the next query onwards, it will execute quickly. So we will see the difference. Now mappers 1 and reducers 0 because we are not doing any aggregations here. We are simply selecting what are all the fields or what are all the records there inside the table. So we don't want any reducers. So friends, mapper phase is done and there is no reducer phase. So our details output details came. There is employee name, department number and salary came. So now we go for analytical functions. First one is count. Here I already explained you all the analytical functions are used along with over and partition by. Okay. Now I have submitted count analytical function query. Our job started. Total number of map reduced jobs 1. So our job started running and mapper phase is done and reduce phase is in progress. So reduce phase also started and is completed. Now we are going to get the output. So here I already explained you count of employees in each department. So here the first department total employees are 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The second department total employees are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 employees are there in the second department. Similarly, in third department 7 employees are there. So in analytical functions, in each record the count aggregation analytical function will display count of the each department. I already not like aggregation, that is group by, not like a group by function. Now we go for sum, that is sum of the employee salary. Here we have used over and partition by, and over and partition by along with sum. So number of mappers 1, number of reducers 2. So for the next one we will reduce number of mappers. It's taking more time because we have two reducers. So we have to reduce always. Reducers should be less than mappers. That's why it's taking more time. Now we reduce the number of reducers count. So reducer phase is completed and we are going to get the output, that is sum of salary for second. This is the second department. For the second department sum of this, all these sum of salary is 53,765. Similarly for the first department, total salary is 35,572. For all the employees of the department, sum of the salary is 50,086. Now we initialize max number of reducers to 1 because it's taking more time for execution. So now we see average. I have submitted average of the salary analytical function query. Now here we have used along with over and partition by. We can see here mappers are 1 and number of reducers 1. So always for better performance, number of reducers should be less than mappers. We will see now how the work high performance will be. Now we have completed mapper phase, reducer phase started. Reducer phase also completed. You can see average salary. So these are all the salaries 7,912,442. These are all salaries. Average salary of the first department is 7,114.4. Similarly, for second department 7,680.71 something. Similarly for third department 7,155.14 something. Okay, we got the average salary. Now we go for minimum salary. So our job started and executed the mappers 1 and reducers 1. Mapper phase started, reduce phase not yet started. So map phase is done with 100% and reduce. So now reduced phase also over, we got the one. This is the minimum salary. In the first department, the minimum salary is 4215. So we got the 4215. In the second department, minimum salary is 6012. So we got 6012. In third department, 5113 is the minimum salary. So we got minimum salary. Now we go for max salary. So for max, we are using max salary aligned with overrun and partition by. Have submitted max salary query in Hive. Now number of mappers 1 and number of reducers 1. Mapper phase is completed and reducer phase started. Once we complete the reduce phase, we will get the output. So here we have to get max salary. So now max salary in first department is 69620. Max salary in second department is 8905. Max salary in third department is 9307. We got the output correctly. Next we go for rank. Friends, already I have discussed about all these analytical functions theoretically. So rank is, it ranks items in a group. So we will see how rank will work. So number of mappers 1, number of reducers 1. So we have completed map phase, reduce phase started. So rank is nothing but ranks items in a group, such as finding the top n rows for specific condition. Now we got the output. That is rank. For each department, what I told you, here in the first department, we have same salary for Kiran and John. So here 4215. So for those two employees, we have given first rank. The next one is 8998. That is for Praveen. Praveen getting third rank. So second rank is skipped. So here we are skipping one rank. We will see dense rank. I explained you dense rank. It assigns a unique I already explained you dense rank. It is similar to rank but leaves no gaps. Like what we have seen here, second rank is skipped for Praveen. For Praveen, we have given third rank. So second rank is not there in the rank. But in dense rank, we give second rank also. We will see the output now, how it will be. So it is similar to rank, but it leaves no gaps in the ranking sequence when there are ties. So we got the output. So our job completed 100% and we got the output here. If you see the output in the first department, Kiran and John are having same ranks and the Praveen second ranks. We are not skipping any ranks here. Okay, but rank we are giving third, but here second rank. Similarly in the second department, we are having same salary for two members. So second rank we are giving and third rank. Here in the rank we are skipping three, but we are giving the next rank, that is dense rank. Okay friends, we have seen dense rank. Now we go for row number along with over and order by. Row number already I explained you, it assigns a unique sequence number starting from 1 to each row according to the partition and order specification. I have submitted row number along with over and order by. So we got the output, our job execution completed and we got the row number. For the first department, from the first to for all the, we are giving order from based on salary. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 up to 19. We have total 19 records. So we got the output. Next come list. It computes the number of rows whose value is smaller or equal to the value of the total number of rows divided by the current row. So we got the output. Here percent first department 0.26, second department 0.63 and third department 1. Okay, that is total number of rows divided by current row. Okay, next we go for percent rank. It is also similar to comdist, but it uses rank values rather than row counts. So percent rank equal to current rank minus 1 divided by total number of rows minus 1. So our job is completed and we got the output. Here see percent rank for the first department 0, second department 0.27 something, and third department 0.66 something. Okay, so we go for n tile. N tile divides an ordered data set into a number of buckets and assigns an appropriate bucket number to each row. It can be used to divide rows into equal sets and assign a number to each row. I told you one example also. If you have four records, that will be, if you want to split into two, it will be given, the records will get, will have values as 1, 1, 2, 2, something like that. Now our job completed successfully 100%. Here we can see the bucket number 1, 2, because total number of records are 19. We are giving two buckets, we are giving n tile of 2. So total records will be divided into two buckets. So this is one bucket and this one is second bucket. Okay, next lead. The lead function is used to return data from the next row. If the number of records are 1, then it will return null value. So now our job completed successfully with 100%. Here in the first department 4215, the leading record is 4215, so 4215 is displayed. For 4215 leading record is, that is the salary is 8398, so 8398 is displayed. Next for 8398, 9124 is lead, so 9124. For 9124 lead is 9620, so 9620 is displayed. For 9620, there is no leading salary in first department, so it displays null. Okay, similarly for second department and third department. So now we go for lag. Lag function is used to access data from a previous row. The number of rows to lag can optionally be specified. Suppose if there are only one record, it returns null value. So our job is completed. Now lag. For 4215 salary, lag is null. 4215 salary, 4215 is a lag. 8398, 4215 is a lag. 9124, 8398 is a lag. 9620, 9124. Okay. Similarly, for the second department also, and third department. The second department and third department. Okay. Now we go for first. So it returns the first result from an order set. This is the first department. In this, first result is 9124. So 9124 is displayed. In the second department, 8751 is the first one. So 8751 is displayed. I mean return. The third department, 6124 is 26 is the first one, so 6126 return. Okay, so now we go for last. So for last value, it returns the last result from an order set. So our job is completed successfully. Now last salary is in the first record, sorry, in the first department, 4215. 4215 is the last salary. So last salary is displayed. And then here in the second department, 6223 is the last salary. Third department, 7970. So we got 7970. Next, we go for sampling. We have three types of sampling. I already explained you. First, what is sampling? When data volume is extra large, we may need to find a subset of data to speed up data analysis. So here we have three types of sampling: random sampling, bucket table sampling, and block sampling. Now we are running random sampling. Along with, here we use rand function with limit keyword. For better performance of random sampling, we go and use distribute and sort keywords. But we have order by rand statement also there in our aggregation functions. But compared to order by, distribute and sort along with rand limit will give better performance. So in real time, we use rand function with limit keyword and distribute and sort keywords. So those will give good performance. So now map phase is completed and reduce phase is completed and job completed successfully. Now our query is random sampling with two records, limit 2. So we will get two records from our sample. So these are Jiggu and Shohan. We got two records from our Hive table. So we got the one. Next, bucket table sampling. So here, bucket table sampling is a special sampling optimized for bucket tables. The rand function can be and also be used when sampling is on the entire rows. So cluster by column and table sample statement will be more efficient. So here we are using table sample. So, if our HIVE table is bucketed, then we go for bucket table sampling. So, here we got total 3 records. So bucket 2 out of 3. So total is 3 records we have fetched from the entire table out of 19 records. Okay, we got it. So these are all randomly chosen from our input sample table. Next one is block sampling. Block sampling, it allows Hive to randomly pick up n rows of data. Otherwise, n percentage of total data size. Otherwise, n bytes of data. So we can give number of rows, otherwise percentage of data size, or otherwise bytes size of data. So we can give in 3 ways in block sampling. Here we have used table sample 4 rows. So we are selecting 4 rows from our employee table. Now our job completed successfully and we got the output. So here we have retrieved 19 rows, total 19 rows. So what we have given? We have given table of 4 rows. Now here we have selected only employee name from employee table sample 4 rows. So we got all the output. Next one, we are giving percent, 10%. So here we got all the, we have executed and completed successfully. Okay, thank you all friends. See you in the coming video. Bye. Thank you.